Oh my god.
Oh my god.
One eternity later.
Alright, so a week ago I watched the Five Nights at Freddy's movie, and let's just say, my opinions are a little iffy. Now before I start this little mini review, I just want to let y'all know that I am the biggest Five Nights at Freddy's fan in the world.
And this bow tie, he looks cooler than anyone with this bow tie.
I mean, check out my channel, it's filled with Five Nights at Freddy's. And I even got this sticker on my calendar, I took it off of the video. So, you know, y'all better like and subscribe before I get into this. Now, let me touch on the good before I get on the bad, because in my opinion, my personal opinion, I think that there's a lot of bad in the movie that could be fixed. But let's start on the good. Casting in this movie was amazing. I mean, Mike, Vanessa, William Afton, purple guy, you know, like, it was perfect. You know, I liked the lawyer that they had in here too, he was funny. But Mike, he was exactly what I pictured a Mike Smith to be like, you know, that type of character. You know, he has that main character type face that I like, and I think that he was the best choice for this movie. Now, if we talk about Vanessa, you know me, but nah, I'm being for real right now. I think she was a good character, and I know a lot of people didn't say that, but you know, I really like what she did in that movie. Purple guy, I liked him. I liked him as long as he was in the movie before he became Spring Bonnie. Because I did not like the Spring Bonnie, bro. But I'll touch on that later. I liked his charisma. I liked how he added like a little bit of, you know, goofy to the movie. And, you know, just the right amount. Not that fort building scene that they had up in there. I don't know what that was about. Music. Top tier. I still got that one song that they played in my head. You know, Secrets That You Keep. Talking in your sleep, something like that. But I think it was a perfect, you know, vibe for a Five Nights at Freddy's band song, you know? Like, it had that Chuck E. Cheese level of music, you know? I like that. I like that choice of song. Also, that opening credit theme, that it eats. That was perfect. And the animation they had with the 8-bit, there was no better way to start off a Five Nights at Freddy's movie with that. The fan service, the cameos, that was great, but that will lead me into why I did not like the Five Nights at Freddy's movie. To start off, we got the fan service. And no, I'm not talking about the gritty part of the Five Nights at Freddy's fans. You know, the day one Five Nights at Freddy's fans. I don't know if they like this movie or not, honestly, because everybody's so mixed on it. But the newer fans and the kids that came to see this movie, there was a lot of kids in my theater. You know, there's a lot of kid Five Nights at Freddy's fans, and it's fine because it's starting to turn into a kid series. But, you know, I was a kid when I liked this movie, and I'm grown. But Five Nights at Freddy's isn't what I thought the fort building scene was, and that just ruined the movie for me in a way. I was like, why are these animatronics building a fort acting all? Here's the reason why I didn't really think this movie worked. It's because the animatronics were acting human. They were acting like kids. They were showing emotions like anger. Like when somebody walks across the screen, Bonnie's like, come on now, Bonnie, if you're trying to be intimidating, you should be like, that kid element didn't work. And people are saying it worked because, like, they're kids in the suits and the animatronics, but like, they're possessed. They really lack the possessed feel. Like, they didn't feel possessed by kids. They felt like they just were kids. Ugh, I just broke the ring. A perfect example of the possessed aspect of Five Nights at Freddy's. The little animations that people make online for the past years since the game is released. And not gonna lie, on the topic of animations that fans make, the spring lock scene, they did not do that justice. You hear this TikTok sound of the spring trap scene where it's like gory and everything. I'm not saying it should have been gory rated R, But I'm saying they could have done more with that scene, you know, like that, like on. And I thought it would be different with Spring Bonnie because, you know, he's human and he's supposed to act like that. But then he just turned into like a fucking generic villain. He was overplaying that role. I liked it better when he was just purple guy. And, you know, like being goofy. And, like, if he brought more of that into the Spring Bonnie suit, that would have worked perfectly. But then he started screaming, "I am the killer." If he was more smooth and, like, menacing with it, like, "Yes, I am Spring Bonnie." And honestly, that reveal did shock me. It did, because they really, like, I don't know, they sold the idea to me. Like, that he was, I thought he was just gonna be phone guy at that point. And so I was like, I was genuinely wondering who's under that mask, you know? So for some reason, I didn't expect it. But even that one scene where he says, "I always come back," that delivery was just not it. You know, you said, "I always come back." Like, nah, there was a much better way to play that part. And yeah, I know I'm a little late to this review, but to be fair, in my state, there was a maniac on the loose, literally killing people, and they had to shut down my theater. So I had to see it the day after. But in that time, I got the chance to really dwell on the movie, and I learned that it's a movie that I think I'll start to love to hate. But the second one, they got a nail. Like, they could spend more, they could do what they should have done, spend more time in the pizzeria. And don't get me wrong, I like the dream scenes, but at some point it just started to get repetitive. Like, we could have been focusing on the lore of the movie. For example, I don't even know if they gave a reason on why William was killing those kids. I mean, there's a reason in the games, but I'm not sure they had one in the movie. I'm sorry if I'm wrong. I'm positive I'm not. I do think they did the merging of the three games, Five Nights at Freddy's 1, 2, and 3, pretty well, actually. There was one scene, though, in the dreams, I think it was, where the kid screams and there's black tears coming out of his eyes. I actually, like, I did, like, a little nod of respect to that scene because, you know, I did want the kids to be, like, more ghost-like, even in the dreams. Like, I kind of wanted them to be, like, black figures with, like, you know, tears coming down their eyes or something like that. But I think that they did that pretty good because it was like a nod to like the crying, you know, the crying ghost children. But instead, I just felt like they were goofy. The animatronics were goofy, man. I don't know. They could have just completely cut that scene easily and had instead, you know, scary robots. Even that one scene where the animatronics are fucking killing everybody, like, they are too human. They need to move robotically. They can't show anger in their eyes. The red eyes, the angry expressions that they have in their face, it doesn't work. They're supposed to be scary. When you make like something that looks kid friendly angry, it just looks goofy. That's something that they really didn't figure out in this movie. How? That's like the main premise. Yes, I'm not the only person who has this opinion. I mean, there was a fight in a theater. I'm not really sure what that was about, but I kind of understand. Like, I could have thrown hands at that movie. If somebody was like, "Yeah, that was the best movie I've ever seen," I'd be like, "Fuck, no, it's not. That movie was dog shit." And that's what I said to somebody I didn't know at the theater. There was a group of kids. And I was like, "Yeah, this movie's dog shit." And they were like, "Yeah, that movie's dog shit." And I was like, "Yeah." And the fact that they even played the Five Nights at Freddy's song at the end, I think it was, I actually like that. But at the same time, I was just like, I just watched a shit movie and are you gonna tickle me with my favorite song of all time? Like, come on. You're not gonna win me over like that. So that's about it. That's my review for the Five Nights at Freddy's movie. The movie that I've been waiting for since I was born. You know, I was made for this movie. Just so I can hate it. But yeah, guys, I'm gonna start uploading more often. You know, if you look at my channel, you should definitely do that. I haven't been uploading as much as I should have. But, you know, the government stopped giving me checks for that type of stuff. So, you know, I had no reason to entertain the public no more. But yeah, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, you know, all of that. So have a good one.